Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, they say that you can give free only for 90 days, 3 months. So October, November, December 2016, it is over. Again, as a new year offer, Reliance Jio introduced again a free offer, another 3 months. The free means government will lose money, because when the private operators, they are working, they are selling their product, means they have to pay the license fees to the government, and whatever the revenue they get, they have to share with the government. When it is free, means government will not get. So it is against the law. Then TROI, one DOT secretary, Mr. J.S. Deepak Misra, wrote to TROI chairman stating that it is complete violation what Reliance Jio is doing. So we have to take action, otherwise government will lose money also. That file went and the file came back. You will not believe that the J.S. Deepak Misra, the DOT secretary who wrote the letter, was transferred. So the hurdle was removed, another secretary was appointed, then naturally they gave another 3 months free. In terms of, we can say, it's called a predatory pricing. You know, I can tell you an example. This pen is 10 rupees. If I sell it for 5 rupees, it is called predatory pricing. It is the predatory pricing will kill the opponents. So in the world itself, people will not accept predatory pricing. But in India, Reliance Jio did predatory pricing, not only predatory pricing, they did no-cost pricing also. So naturally, as a human psychology, when it is free, people will go for it. So they grabbed the subscribers in the country. They get more. And number two, they got an advantages from the government also. Number two, they approached the government. They said, Reliance Jio told the Prime Minister office that they have to reduce the inter-usage charges. That inter-usage charges means if any network, I am using BSNL network, you are using Reliance Jio, you are calling me, then Reliance Jio has to pay 14 paisa per minute to BSNL. This is inter-usage charges. It's a vice versa also. But Reliance Jio entered late, so their subscriber base is less. So they have to pay more IUC charges. So they went to government, you reduce it. Airtel earlier went, government did not agree. Vodafone earlier went, government did not agree. But Reliance Jio went, now the government agreed to that. They have reduced from 14 paisa to 6 paisa per minute. At a stroke, government lost 5,000 crores. At a stroke, Reliance Jio got the total benefit. So that is why Reliance Jio could grab the subscribers throughout the country. In the March 2019, this Reliance Jio, they have added 1 crore subscriber in 1 month. And 76 lakhs of connections from Vodafone. 26 lakhs of connections from Airtel. And in this situation, BSNL gave 3.5 lakhs connection as a positive one, number one. Number two, why BSNL is suffering? The suffering is due to the non-expansion, and especially the government did not allot 4G spectrum to the BSNL. Three companies, they are having 4G spectrum. And the competition means there will be equal footing. Everybody says that in the privatization, if you say equal footing should be there, where is the question of equal footing for BSNL? BSNL, still now, we have not been allotted 4G spectrum at all. Reliance Jio is having, Airtel is having, Vodafone is having. They are giving the services to the public, but we cannot give the service to the public. As a union, we have demanded this allotment of 4G spectrum to BSNL. We have demanded with the government. We went on strike for 3 times. Every time the telecom minister will give assurance that 4G spectrum will be allotted to you, they have not allotted. On February 2018, they assured us it will be given within a month's time, 4G spectrum, they did not give. Again, we gave a strike notice on December 3rd, indefinite strike throughout the country from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari. We gave a call, minister invited us, all the official, topmost bureaucrats were there. In front of them, they gave it in writing that they will give 4G spectrum to BSNL. And in the parliament, they will say that they will give. If anybody raise a question, they will say that, yes, we are going to give 4G spectrum to BSNL. But still, we are lacking behind. So non-allotment of 4G spectrum, we could not expand our business. And one more pathetic condition, the government is crippling us. Number one, Reliance Jio, they have invested 1,50,000 crore rupees, out of which they got bank loan 1.25 lakh crores. That's from the nationalized bank they got loan. So only 25,000 crores they have invested, they have started the business. Today, I am talking about 2016, 1.5 lakh crore. Today, Reliance Jio's debt is 2 lakh crores. And what about Vodafone? 1,20,000 crores. Airtel, 1,13,000 crores. These huge debts are there from the nationalized banks. If they did not pay, means bank will go bankrupt. Bad debts will increase. But BSNL is having only a loan of 10,000 crores. So for the expansion of BSNL, we ask the government, you give bank loan to us also. For that, we need a letter of comfort. That government has to give it to us. 20,000 crores or 30,000 crores as a bank loan we would like to get. But government did not give letter of comfort to us at all. Our asset, BSNL asset, as per the market value, it is 4 lakh crores. It is our asset. In our corporate office, we have got a building, our own building. They have assessed this, the one building costs about 2,500 crores. So we got an asset. And we got a vacant land also. So we asked, the BSNL management asked the government, we have got vacant lands are there. We can monetize it. You please permit us. They have asked, they wrote a letter in 2018 after the board decision. And our assessment is 1 lakh crore worth of vacant land is there. It went to government. Government returned the file. They say that the land is not in the name of BSNL. It is in the name of Department of Telecom. So we are deprived of everything.